In today's video, I'm going to explain what Selenium Grid is, show how to create a local Selenium Grid, and then use the Galen example from the previous video to run some tests against our local Selenium Grid. So, let's start! Selenium Grid is a set of services or applications that allows us to create a testing environment in which we can test against different combinations of browsers and operating systems. You can also use it to run tests in parallel. Selenium consists of two parts: a hub that receives the Selenium tests commands, like click on this button or enter some text on a text field, and passes them to the appropriate nodes. Then we have the nodes, which register themselves against the Selenium hub, providing to it the information of each node's running environment, like the operating system, for example Windows, Linux or Mac, browser like Firefox or Chrome, and the version. With this information, the hub selects in which nodes the tests should be run, given the desired capabilities requested by the tests. For example, the test might specify that it wants a Chrome browser using the latest version and also running on a Mac OS machine. Finally, the nodes are the ones that execute the tests against the browser. So, normally, you would have your tests, and using Selenium WebDriver, you would execute the test commands against a page using a local Firefox or Chrome browser. When using Selenium Grid, you would have some differences. You have your tests, as before, but now your test commands are sent to the hub, which will take the specified desired capabilities, select a node that matches them, and then, using Selenium WebDriver, will start executing the test commands against that node's browser. Given that there are already Docker images for a Selenium Grid hub and nodes for different browsers like Chrome and Firefox, I'm going to use them without making any changes. I have created an environment file in which I've defined the default values for the environment variables, the domain name or IP for the Selenium hub, and the port in which it is listening. Then I created a docker-compose.yml file with three services. The first service is called hub and is the one defined for the Selenium hub image. I also exposed the 4444 port. I'm using the environment variable here, which allows me to override it using the command line. Then a Chrome node, for which I use the Selenium node Chrome image, and also configure some environment variables needed by the Docker container to know where the hub is by using the name of the service and the port as well. I am also using here environment variables, but the ones defined before for the compose file. Finally, I define the Firefox node service with the Selenium node Firefox image and the same environment variables pointing to the same hub service. Before starting the containers, let's check the current configuration. It seems that it's taking the default values that we defined on the .env file. Let's override the port configuration. This might depend on how to set and clear environment variables for your current operating system. And try again and check the configurations for Docker Compose. Seems to be working. Let's clear the variable and start our containers. Open the have URL on your browser using the IP and the 4444 port. Then click on console. And then you will be able to see that we have two nodes, one per browser. Let's do one last test and scale the Chrome node so that we have 5 instances instead of 1. In the Test a Simple Web Application using Docker and Galen video, I created a project in Galen for testing a simple web application. In that video, I tested against Sauce Labs and Browser Stack. Let's use the same code, but this time we will use our local Selenium grid. For that, let's go into our projects folder and run the Galen container. Specify the folder for the tests, where the reports should be located, that we are using a Selenium grid and the IP for the Selenium grid hub. Open again the URL for the hub to see what is happening. We can see that one of the nodes is in use. Finally, as before, we can see the report in a web format by opening the report.html file located under the newly created reports folder. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! And if you like the video, please hit subscribe!